Hi, my name is Sanjeev Gupta and I am from Kendriya Vidyalaya at Ganesh Nagar, Pune. The title of the project is Identification and Studies on Cost-Effective and Long-Lasting Muscular Repairing Molecules on Cotton Cloth. As per WHO, 7 million people are in danger in 128 countries all over the world. Mosquitoes are a menace in this world. This deadly animal has made prone 5 million people all over the world. The present methods to repair mosquitoes are vaporizers, mats, coils, lotions, creams, gels, and roll-on fabrics. Vaporizers, mats have problem that they cause breathing problems. Lotions, creams, and gels trigger allergies on people's skin. The most ideal method until now was the roll-on fabric, that is application of our compound onto the fabric. But this also has its own defects. It is not permanent. It is temporary on the cotton cloth and gets away after one or two washes. So I wanted to make permanently muscular repairing cloths. So first of all, I thought which is the thing that is permanent on the cloths. The answer is the dyes. The dyes are permanent on the cloths. You wash them thousands of times, it will come off. So, I have tried to identify the mechanism of dyes by many scientific papers proposed. So the dye, a typical dye such as this, works in this way. This part of the dye gives the color, and the red colored moiety or the part of the dye doesn't give the color but gives it the property to attach to cotton cloths. Cotton is a cellulosic biopolymer with massive number of hydroxyl groups. So using these displacement of hydroxyl groups and chlorines, the dyeing process takes place. So similarly, I have thought about modifying a muscular repellent molecule to such that it can be attached with the cotton cloth through dyeing processes. So to do so, I have taken a compound, a mosquito repellent called Icardin. I have chosen this mosquito repellent because this has the OH group, hydroxyl group, which helps in bonding with the cyanuric chloride. The cyanuric chloride is a compound which is used to bond with the cotton cloths. So after reacting, the product came out to be Icardin triazine and I named it SAHO-1. The testing data of SAHO-1 is over here. I have compared the data of SAHO-1 and Icardin. SAHO-1 at 4 gram per liter concentration showed 100% of repellence, and Icardin, whereas at 1 gram per liter itself, showed 100% of repellence. This is because of modification, it lost some of its properties but could be retained. So this has an advantage over this, that it can be attached to the cotton cloth. So further, now I went to do the dyeing processes. For dyeing processes, I had to consult the textile department in ICT Mumbai. They suggested me a method which is used in the industries. After dyeing with the cotton cloth, again it was tested. For testing, a chamber was designed as per the international standards of WHO CTD. In this, as you can see, a box is divided into three compartments in the ratio 1:2:3. Then the mosquitoes are let in, and the migration from one side where the cloth is, from migration from this side to the other side is the mosquito repellence measured. So at different concentrations, 1, 2 and 4 gram per liter concentrations, at 4 gram per liter concentration, SAHO-1 showed 90% of repellence. After that, now to check the permanency, I had to do the wash-to-wash analysis. In the wash-to-wash analysis, the cloth was washed for 10, 20 and 50 washes. And SAHO-1 had 60% repellence remaining. And here is the cloth which is modified with SAHO-1. Now, this cloth of 1 meter square costs between 14 to 20 rupees, and this could be applied to everybody in the world. It is cost-effective and long-lasting. Hence, every school child will not be scared.